Welcome to Magic Gathering Strat. I'm Dan, and I have played a deck in Standard Pauper that you have seen. It's Flickergate, and it's just one of many different iterations of this deck. And I was going to think about this: what Flickergate means, and what you need to do with it. And I want your opinions as well. First of all, I would like a list of all the major archetypes in Standard Pauper. Anybody has such a list? Avery, I'm looking at you. Cause what I have in... I have such a list in the normal Pauper, of course. And I want to make a template for the decks of Standard Pauper. Of course they will rotate, which sucks. But this is like... list as it looks for normal Pauper. So I know there is like the Dimir Mill deck. I can probably delete all of these. There is the Celestia midrange. There is the Bant Flicker deck. What else? There is Gruul Aggro. There is Boros Aggro. Tell me what else there is. There is Blue Flyers. But these are just decks I've seen, and I'm not sure they're really archetypes. Please add more archetypes to this list. Okay, we have been using a Flickergate deck for Standard Pauper that comes from the original request. This deck was the most proven tournament deck Bodadam could find, and I'll show you the webpage. This is the Flickergate deck I've been using. Some of the stuff in the deck seems so random. The one-off creatures and the one-off spells. Of course you have four Archaeomancers. But is this really the best? Also, here is the sideboard. What do we want to do with the sideboard? What are we really afraid of? So let's look at the deck. I'm playing with this sideboard now, for the time being. We want something against our Archaeomancer plus Flicker. We want something against Mill Graveyard Hate. Okay, so let's look at the core of the deck. In this thread, where the other Flickergate was, the other Flickergate was in this thread, let me show you. There is a discussion about the Flickergate decks. This deck really went all in on the Smeltward Gatekeepers. But for the Smeltward Gatekeepers to be good, you really need Flicker. So I don't agree with that. I think this deck is better. We need our Archaeomancer, the Flickers, the Gatecreeper Wines. How many... We have 12 gates. So maybe 12 gates is enough. Four black Gatekeepers. And the other, the white Gatekeeper, just putting a knight into play, it's not good enough. Drawing a card is not good enough, because we can do that with Elvish Visionary. And maybe the Smeltward Gatekeeper is the staple. And for Elvish Visionary too, for the extra targets. So what is then optimal? So the core is... Then 25 cards. We have 22 lands. And leaves us with 13 optional cards. And this guy made the choice to run one Bloodhunt Bat, one Prophetic Prism. Prophetic Prism looks really good. Borderland Ranger, I like him. One Mist Raven, one, two Clinging Mists. Do you really need them? I've only played three real duels with the deck, right? Or four? I even don't remember. But I think the Clinging Mists are not super good. Tragic Slip is always super good. Is this 13 cards? No. It's 10. What three cards? One Forbidden Alchemy. This also is 24 creatures, which could be important. 25, 40, this is not 13, this is 11. We're missing two. What are we missing? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 with the Essence Scatter, 8, 11, Grave Exchange and Inaction Injunction, which seems super random. Grave Exchange is for being able to bring back the Smelt Ward Gatekeeper, as you will win the game with him. And you don't want him to die. Right? Return target creature from graveyard to your hand. Target play. Okay, we can play that. Get the Smelt Ward back, or worst case, getting an Archaeomancer back. But in action injunction. Why are we not even playing more Gatekeepers? Oh, there is a Hexproof deck in the format, right? I played it myself. I don't know if it's a thing, but Hexproof tends to be a thing. It was a very successful video the first time I did Standard Pauper Hexproof, but when I did it again, no one really cared, so I haven't cared about it since then. I did one versus Dimir Control. Yeah, Dimir Control-ish flicker decks is a thing, right? So Dimir Flicker Control. Looking once again at the sideboard. I understand that Devour Flesh are for the Hexproof deck. Dispel is for a deck with a lot of counterspells, removals. There's a Delver deck in the format as well, right? That's a very huge deck, isn't it? It's a Delver. So, let's look at the curve here. The curve is, of course, very centric at 4. And what else would we want? What are staples in Standard Pauper, really? I'm so new to the format. Metagame. I'm looking here. But if they say Standard, do they mean Standard Pauper? Is it Semi-Storm? Is it Blitz? The Blue Horde. Yeah, this looks like... Oh, he won with this. But this is what I meant with Blue Flyers, pretty much. So we need our sideboard from standard blues. Yeah. Oh, the Cyclops deck. Of course, Grixis Cyclops, right? Or Nivix. Finding names for the standard Pauper decks. Not easy. I'm saying Nivix, Cyclops, Nivix, Grixis, Cyclops. There seems to be a blue-red and a blue-red-black deck. Is that semi-storm? Why do they say storm? What do you mean by storm? I said this is an... Oh, Delver, Cyclops. Seems like a strong combination. So everything that says standard, there is a Gate Flicker deck. Is it my Gate Flicker deck? Yes, it is. Played by Miliguanmenmen. Rakdos Burn. Nice. Let's put that in the list. Electricity is nice in the sideboard, right? They also have Devour Flesh. Victim of Night seems very powerful. Isn't Victim of Night better than Tragic Slip, mostly? Here is the mill deck. Looks really strong. Well, suddenly I am in Stockholm, the capital of Scandinavia. I already knew that. And Gruul, Blood Rush. 4 Madcap skills. Way. Surta Druid. So nice. So what do I do with this deck? Do I run the same list again? Well, that would make this whole exercise pointless. So we'll look at some more. Ors of Extort. I don't run white in my deck. And the best Extort creature is a Screecher. But the Screecher could also attack in the air. So how about... How about I actually try to main deck? Do I want Alchemy? It is pretty sweet. Okay, I take out one Clinging Mist and one Inaction Injunction. And one Essence Scatter, because I think it's random. This is too many Screechers to put in at one time, right? They will block, they will be a win con. Let's just try it and see where it goes. I probably tap out every turn from flickering and stuff, but if I don't... But I need black mana for it. It seems super slow. What about just putting in prisms? Making the deck thinner. Also giving us a better curve here. Looks pretty good. Okay. That's what I'm gonna go with here. Please give me opinions on how to improve the deck. I don't normally take opinions for improving decks, actually, because my decks are usually brewed by somebody else. But this is one of the things I love with Standard Pauper. It's so unexplored. And I would love to play the PREs. I would love it. They are on very bad hours, sadly. But if you see one that it is in on a weekday European time during working hours, then I'm up for it. Thank you for watching Magic Gathering Strat. I've been thinking about Flickergate in Standard Pauper. Thank you for watching.